guy's looking to gain the advantage. A good right hand there by Khan.
Of Khan's 19 knockouts have occurred inside 8 rounds. He has 6 first-round stoppages, while Collazo has 3 first-round KOs. Khan along the ropes momentarily.
Collazo stalking carefully.
Mir Khan has found a home for the right hand and is trying to. He's spent the whole round circling to his right, which you're not supposed to do against the lefty, and yet he's had some success.
Collazo looking for his first win in Las Vegas, having previously lost to Shane Mosley, and controversially on Showbox, his first loss of his career against Edwin Cassiani 12 years ago, April of 2002.
Collazo's got to be careful to maintain that composure.
And part of
Khan stings Collazo with the right.
Part of the reason that Khan is actually moving to his right is to stay away from the right hook of Collazo, because Collazo is not as good a puncher with the left hand as he is the right hook.
No ring rust being showcased yet. But catching Collazo again with the right hand, holding onto his arm. However, again, a veteran move that referee Dracula is just letting him get away with.
Yeah, a lot of holding by Mir Khan.
You're holding. Now cut it out.
Finally,
he heard you, Marl.
Thank you.
Collazo tried to get the hook going there, and that's the punch he's going to want to land.
More holding there by Khan. Khan doesn't like the view.
Lead left hook and overhead.
Collazo switching but getting caught in the switches, so this isn't working so well for him.
Wanting to work
like this long as a righty.
Eats another left hook. All one-way traffic here for Amir Khan. Finally, Collazo goes to the body with a solid right. So a good start for the youngest British fighter ever to win an Olympic medal, Amir Khan at 147.
There it goes again. John Ruiz-esque at times.
Yeah, he's a heavyweight who, of course, was notorious for doing some holding. And Khan dominating this bout with his punches landed, according to show stats.
Very one-sided stat.
Collazo stalking Khan, but he's not getting off. He's got to find a way to stalk and get the punches off as well. Khan has done a good job. And when he does get close, Khan always continues that holding.
It's been an uneven and wild effort so far by Luis Collazo. Not been precise with his punches.
Initiating the offense, again going to the body and escaping. So we are through 3 rounds here at the MGM Grand, and Jim Gray standing by with...
If Floyd leaves 46-0, he'll have some bragging rights as well.
There's no doubt about
Mike,
it.
Always great to be with you.
Always with you too, Jim.
Mo?
Collazo goes down here in round 4 and drags.
As Khan was blocking the view here. But.
Khan all over Collazo as Collazo goes down for the first time since October of 2011 when he was knocked down against Freddie Hernandez. Great hearing from Mike Tyson as Collazo now executes a combination, and enjoyed visiting with Tyson a bit at the awards dinner the other night. Congratulations to our Paulie Malignaggi and Jimmy Lennon Jr., who were both honored.
Thanks, Mo.
Congrats, Paulie.
Thanks, Al.
And, you know, the combination punching of Amir Khan in this fight has been impressive.
Impressed you the most about Khan's performance, Al?
I think that Amir Khan, the combination punching and the way he's been able to place his punches have been very, very good.
Conversely, Paulie, you know Collazo better than anyone here as he now goes to work on Amir Khan. Anything you would like to see him do different to make adjustments?
There's a lot of times he's stalking Khan down, but he's not able to get off first. He does all the work, and then Khan gets off first. And he's done a much better job
in this round, you're right.
And getting off first. It's important if you're going to stalk your opponent when you reach him that he doesn't get off before you. And Collazo's done a better job this round. Problem is he got knocked down early in the round, so still not going to win him the round.
Walking down Amir Khan in what has been a terrific fourth in the final minute now of this round.
adventures in the ring in terms of getting knocked down. There's always that collective holding your breath. Will he get hurt by something? And Collazo is starting to land meaningful punches.
Collazo is walking him down with his hands down. I mean, he's totally not expecting the power of Khan.
That's what makes Khan such a fan-friendly fighter. You never know what you're going to get, but here we're getting maybe the very best of Amir Khan. Going to work on Louis Collazo. It's been a back and forth, very spirited round.
The knockdown, it's been Collazo's best round.
Good point, Paulie Malignaggi. One of the reasons why you were honored as broadcaster of the year as we go to the fifth round here in Las Vegas.
Well, I'm making that one 10-9, guys.
This is where Amir Khan was able to create a knockdown. Right hand, a very good right hand, and an appropriate call by Vic Draculas. And again, he's squaring himself up, Collazo. Totally squared up, and he gets nailed with a very, very good right hand. And you got to give Louis Collazo credit for getting up and not having this impact him. A good short right hand.
You also got to give Khan credit for throwing such a short right hand.
I was going to say,
there was not a lot of room
short
there.
Right.
And Khan was able to get some leverage on the short right hand.
The bell goes and we begin round number five. Collazo spent 2.5 weeks at the largest training facility in the U.S., Fort Jackson Military Base in South Carolina, where he's trained for the majority of his fights since 2008. He completed training, though, back in New York City. He's in touch here against Amir Khan as they go toe-to-toe to kick off the fifth.
Hey, put your head down, man. Cut it out. Stop it now. Okay, let's go. Stop.
Amir Khan pushing the head down of Collazo, and that's when Collazo threw that. That shot.
It does get frustrating, man. I mean, I fought Khan. Let's not forget he got points taken.
Utilized 2 points against Lamont Peterson. One for pushing and one, both were for pushing, actually. So Khan is not above bending the Marcus of Queensbury rules.
And he does it in smart ways. I mean, a lot of times he doesn't like the look he's getting, so he'll push you away or he'll push your head down. It's smart on his part, or he'll hold you like he's doing here. Smart on his part. It's not his job to enforce the rules. It's the referee's job.
When I say stop, I mean stop. Let go of that arm.
I'm the referee telling Collazo when I say stop, I mean stop, but you're allowed to work when you're the one being held.
And he was working the left hand, his free arm. Khan along the ropes, flashing the jab. Collazo again with his hands down.
Collazo had a 6-week training camp for this fight, rare for him. Only 4 weeks when he fought Hatton, 3 when he fought Mosley, in fights he did well in.
Oh.
He thinks that's going to make an impact as this fight continues.
Well, those right and left hand made an impact on his face from him. He continues to just walk down Khan.
From a game plan perspective, Khan has fought a very good fight. Very smart tactical game plan from him and Virgil Hunter.
Pretty close round five, though. They have it's an interesting round to score.
Collazo not cutting off the ring, and Khan coming forward now and again. Rough and tumble affair on the inside. Double jab followed by the straight right hand by Khan. And now Collazo with the right hand behind the guard. We're going to the sixth round here in Sin City. Unified welterweight title fight between Floyd Mayweather and Marcos Maidana. And Virgil Hunter told us something, guys, at the fighter meeting. He said that Khan has begun to understand why he's gotten hit with punches that he doesn't see, and something that will serve him well in his future as a fighter. There's a right hand and a left hook by Khan. Collazo comes back and manages to connect with that right hand behind the guard.
If there's a punch that Collazo's going to make a big impact with and hurt Khan, it's going to be the right hook. And he has landed a few, but not the way he wants to.
It's out. It's probably something they've worked on in the gym in terms of an extra escape route.
There's a left uppercut followed by the right hand and another right from Collazo. Big George Foreman defense there, Paul.
Yeah. Then he holds or he smothers. There it is again. He doesn't like what he's doing there. He's going to push Collazo's head down.
You know, I don't think Collazo is necessarily instigating all of that. Some of it's because his head low, but
I fought Amir Khan myself, and I saw the Lamont Peterson fight where he lost points for that kind of stuff. It's very frustrating because he's so tough to cut distance against. He's got a great jab and fast hands. When you finally get close, you feel like you're finally going to be able to do something, and then he holds you or he pushes your head down. And if the ref doesn't do anything about it, it becomes the most frustrating thing in the world. And that's what Collazo's feeling right now. You see the faces he's making. Finally gets all the work, does all the work to get in close, and then he gets held. And then you saw Khan get down low to get off the ropes there. And that's what I mean about what I said earlier, guys. Khan slides out. He's got an extra almost escape route now when he gets himself low like that.
The first half of this 12-round affair is in the books as Khan lands a straight right.
In this has been the right hand of Amir Khan. Again, it is Collazo just leaving himself exposed. And
Pauly, this was supposed to be an audition for a big fight in the future. How do you think Amir Khan has fared thus far in his first fight at 147?
He's looked impressive. He's got a solid fighter in front of him, and he's done well. He's got a good game plan he's implementing. Like I said earlier, it's not his job to be the referee. It's up to the referee to do his job. And, you know, the game plan Khan has been enforcing has been good, and it's worked.
Point. We know what Khan's weakness is as a fighter. It's his chin. And Collazo has to keep his confidence up because this fight might not be over. And Collazo will have a chance to win because of that chin, even if he's way behind on the cards.
Oh, and he just ate that solid right hand from Khan.
Now he's actually sticking to a game plan the entire time.
Quick combination by Khan.
Very close round here, though, in round seven. And yet, still in a round that he may not have won.
Another low blow by Collazo, but again, Khan pushing his head down. Oh, and Pauly, your worst nightmares come true. Unbelievable.
I mean, he's pushing his head down. He's pushing his head down all night. I mean, there's nothing you can do when you finally get that close and you can't seem held to pushing your head down. It's so frustrating, like I said. If the referee doesn't do anything to enforce those rules, you're going to get broken up, you're going to go back on the outside, and you start over, and you know how difficult it's going to be to get back close again.
So it sticks the jab, follows with the right hand, and there's a holding by Khan.
It affects the fight, though. I mean, like I said, sure Amir is smart. I mean, if you're going to get away with it, Amir's smart. Amir's gotten away with it a lot in his career, and it's smart game planning because on the outside, he's very sharp, and it's very hard to cut distance. I mean, this is where he's king, on the outside. When you get close, you finally want to get the work you want to get in because Amir is not very sharp inside, and he doesn't bend his knees inside, and he stands straight up inside. So that's why he holds or he pushes your head down. He doesn't know how to fight inside. So you get inside, you want to finally work, and you can't because you're being held to get your head pushed down. It's frustrating because now the ref breaks you, and you're back on the outside, and you have to start all over again to get past that laser jab of Amir.
7 rounds, or I guess his running total.
When you land 50% of your power punches, that's spectacular, and that's what Khan has done here. Despite all the rest, he is accurate with his punches tonight. Oh, big shot by Collazo.
Khan smiling at him, but Collazo and Amir again holding on. And if referee drives, there you go. Finally telling Khan that if you do it again, I'm taking a point away.
Let's see.
First time Collazo has hurt him.
Amir seems to have his legs under him, but Luis got to move his hands. There it is again with the head. Oh, good one too by Khan. He seems to have his legs back under him good.
Collazo walking in with the lead left.
Some drama going in the fight.
Khan holding on again. And if that was and finally, I think the point. Timeout.
1 point. Hold
on. And the crowd reacting.
Well, I guess the crowd feels Luis Collazo's frustration, you know.
In the round after that left hand had hurt Amir Khan, it would be Khan that would be penalized later on in the round for holding, and Collazo ripping those left hands and can't get his arm away from Khan, and Khan, after several warnings, has a point deducted.
So the bell in round number 9, quick start for Amir Khan as he comes out firing. And to summarize the action thus far, 20 seconds into round 4, Collazo went down from a right hand. And in the round we just saw, referee Vic Draculic deducting a point for low blows from Collazo. And
then comfortably ahead, despite all the things that happened in the last round. That, of course, very unofficial. And we don't know how the judges are seeing it, but Amir Khan has certainly done good work in this fight.
Collazo pushing the issue a lot this round now. Collazo getting more and more Brave with those big shots now as he's able to get in close, and Amir's not able to hold. Oh, the sharp combination there by
Amir.
Yeah,
very sharp combination, and now Collazo comes back with a combination of his own.
And that's because Amir didn't hold, because now the point deduction is on his mind. You see how he threw the combination, he didn't hold, he just laid in there, so Collazo was able to respond.
This fight's starting to become a little Peterson-esque, with Khan starting to move around this ring and look for sanctuary. We'll see how that continues.
And the point deduction
down, shoots out the right, and chance of Louis now. Nice emerge from a part of the crowd.
Nice escape there by Khan on the ropes. Like I said earlier, he gets down low now off the ropes as well.
Khan's landing some good counter right hands in this round.
Collazo avoiding that attack. So another action-packed round here as we go to round number 10 in Las Vegas.
Good counter right hand there.
The advice from Collazo's corner, don't let them take it from you. While Virgil Hunter in Khan's corner wants him to continue to use his jab.
And let me say, you know,
I mean, Khan doesn't want you in his chest. So if you get close, you know, he's going to do what he want, what a defensive fighter would do. He's going to hold or push your head down. It's up to the referee to enforce that. But Khan fighting a good game plan now.
Three punch combination by Khan. Sorry, I'll go ahead.
Collazo has never had a knockout this late in a fight, so he's got to do something precedent setting if he's going to win this match, probably, if he's behind.
Oh, the left hook to the body hurt Collazo.
Good body shot by Khan.
And the right and left, and now Khan pouring on the pressure. Short left hook to the jaw, but Collazo's absorbing it.
He got the advantage in the round. Got the body shot. Yeah, he got it in there.
Or make that Collazo.
On Khan's part, I thought he was resting. What he was doing was jockeying his hands for position so he could shift Collazo's hands.
And Khan sensing, and Collazo down again. And a left hook and a right. Khan on fire here now, all over Louis Collazo, wanting to close the show, but Collazo doing a good job of avoiding much of the attack. And Khan again pushing Collazo's head down.
Collazo waiting for him to get on the ropes. Slippery on the ropes, but Khan should go to the body.
Four times in round 10. And Khan wanting to send a message.
Oh. Even though this has been a rough, he has shown great combinations and done excellent work to the body.
Good combination by Collazo.
And Khan telling Collazo it doesn't hurt or something to that effect.
Sticks the right hand, goes Amir Khan. Collazo eats a couple of jabs. There's a left hook to the body. Good right hand by Collazo. Lands the left. So good combination there by the Brooklyn fighter. Headed to the 12th and a final round of this welterweight matchup. Amir Khan, Louis Collazo going to the final 3 minutes.
Three in 12 rounds, and Amir Khan is 3-1 in 12 rounds, so they have different experience in going this.
Trying to get out of the round in one piece.
Both of them have been marked up. There's the speed on display from Amir Khan, and now Collazo returns. Fire. You wonder how much is left from Louis Collazo, who does look exasperated, frustrated, and frankly spent.
He's the one coming forward. But Khan, in good shape, maintaining the game plan, not taking chances. He knows he's ahead in round 12.
Yeah, I think it's more. Right cross by Khan. So as we wrap things up, a good performance for Amir Khan over a year layoff, coming back at 147 pounds and putting on display here against a very tough out in Louis Collazo.
The numbers in this match demonstrate the big edge for Amir Khan.
All three in favor of the winner, Amir Khan.